Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'd. Ahabati fillah. One of the reasons that we try to emphasize Tawheed is because this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called to. And he began his da'wah, his call to. And he ended his call with. It's Tawheed Allah. And that it was just pure Iman and Tawheed that the Prophet began with in the beginning of his call. Because Tawheed is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we have to try our best to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his right in order that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us forgiveness and grant us his mercy and grant us his rahmah and grant us jannah bi-idhnillah tabarak wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith of Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala an, Mu'adh radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, kuntu radif nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala himar faqal ya Mu'adh atadri ma haqq Allah al-ibadi wa ma haqq al-ibadi ala Allah kuntu Allah wa rasuluhu a'lam. قال حق الله على عباده أن يعبدوه ولا يشركوا به شيئا وحق العباد على الله أن لا يعذب من لا يشركوا به شيئا قلت يا رسول الله أفأبشر الناس وكما قال قال لا تبشرهم فيتقلوا رواه مسلم. In this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I believe it in Sahihain, Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu said, I was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on a donkey. Look at the humbleness of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the leader of the ummah alayhi salatu wasalam. I was on a donkey with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then he asked, he said, O Mu'adh, do you know the right of Allah over his servant and the right of the servant over Allah, meaning us, you and I, we're the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Mu'adh radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Allah and his messenger know best. Look at that, instead of guessing, he gave the, he left this Azeem question, he left that to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to answer. He said, Allah and his messenger know best. That's humbleness. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the right of Allah over his servant is that he worships him and him alone. And the right of the servant over Allah is that he doesn't punish the one who worships him and him alone. That means he yuhaqqiqa tawheed. That's for the person who actualizes fully tawheed. Not just, you know, like you and I, we show off sometimes, and sometimes this, sometimes we have doubt, sometimes, a'udhu billah, may Allah protect us and forgive us of our many shortcomings. But that's for the one who actualizes tawheed, yuhaqqiqa tawheed. And then Mu'adhi said, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should I tell the people this? Should I notify the people of this? Give them the glad tidings? He said, no, because then they will rely on the fact that they worship Allah alone and think that they don't have to do any amal, they don't have to do any deeds. Letting us know Tawheed, part of actualizing Tawheed is actually Tawheed al-Ibadah. That we have to worship Allah. And that shows us also that Iman, a part of Iman is actions. So it's not just what I hold in my heart, and it's not just what I say on my tongue, but it's also the actions that I do. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and bless us to be from Ahl Tawheed, and to be of those who Allah forgives and enters Jannah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.